we got the same problem again.
You want me to read it, but I'll read it.
No, Dave, I'll read it.
You don't get it.
Sit down, Sit back down at the piano.
Just give him a blowjob.
Is someone what's wrong with the teleprompter?
Owen.
BJ Rubin's got a show tonight. He's on the go tonight. He's in the know tonight. When he's rubbing you the wrong way, then you know that he's right. BJ Rubin's got a show. BJ Rubin's got a show. BJ Rubin's got a show tonight.
Power, money, and sex. Who am I to argue? I didn't necessarily seek these things out. They just came to me. How many times have I heard children wonder out loud, "How did he become so powerful?" Or the local vagrant ask, "How did he get so rich?" as I toss him a dime without being asked, advising him never to take advice. More times than I've had sex.
From the moment that I met you, I found the trouble that I've been dreaming of. And now I can't forget you. I don't want to live on my own. If you knew how much I missed you, but from a thunderous revelation from above, you took my money, my car, my dignity away, but I still fell in love. I'll play the song. I missed you, like from a thunderous revelation from above. You took my money, my car, my dignity away, but I still fell in love. And you can't beat that for the money.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the BJ Rubin Show. Tonight, my special guest is Peter Evans. Now, Peter is a trumpet player, but tonight he will not be playing the trumpet. Peter, why is it that you're not playing the trumpet tonight?
I am injured, and I can't play the trumpet right now. Or I can, but it hurts a little bit, and I don't know why. So I brought these three nurses to help me figure out the reason that I can't play.
Restaurant Rib, do you think you're some kind of sub-Saharan African dictator?
I don't know what you're talking about, Weasel. I'm an Ivy League graduate and a professional. I'm trying to contribute to society.
Restaurant Rib, do you think you're some kind of sub-Saharan African dictator?
I don't know what you're talking about, Weasel. I'm an Ivy League graduate and a professional. I'm trying to contribute to society.
Restaurant Rib, do you think you're some kind of sub-Saharan African dictator?
I may not be videotaped, as such actions might capture my spirit. I am leader. I answer to no one. You are lucky you have both hands. Do you see what I mean? I harvest hands. I make my enemies inadequate. That is what I do. My Mercedes is no joke. I take, and then I take. You have nothing that I will not take. Your women? Ha ha ha. I take. So you think you have Range Rover. I now enjoy Range Rover and watch modern movies. Watch them over and over again. At my pleasure.
Thanks for that, Dr. Rib. Now with your permission, we'll watch the next routine. Or should I say, now we watch next routine with your permission. Please do not cut off hand, as it may not be able to sign paycheck.
You to what we're doing.
I will.
Autistic people are a nuisance.
Once, when I was a boy, an alien put it in my butt. the same way again after I first took that first diarrhea crunch. Thank you, Mr. Alien, for ruining my whole life. Now it hurts to piss and shit, and now I cry every time I wet myself in class or at night.
Shit like that.
That's very juvenile for you to do, Big Buddin.
That's my style.
Is he hiding behind his hair in the, on the plant?
Ladies and gentlemen, my friend Nondor Nevai. Nondor, why are you hiding behind the plant?
I can't reveal myself right now.
I'm feeling a bit feminine.
You're feeling a bit feminine. Yeah. What does that mean?
Well, it's hard to tell the truth, even if you think you're being honest. You may not even know the truth. And we don't even know what's true. How can we tell the truth?
Oh, thanks for defining feminine for me. I think I understand now.
Has anyone seen the Virgin Mary? Because I was hoping to give her a forced abortion in case you did. I want to welcome you to the BJ Rubin Show. I want to welcome you, but I'm not going to. I'm not a welcoming person. I'm also not cooperative. I don't take direction well. You never call me in my darkest hour. You never held my hand when skies were gray. I spend the evenings with the ghost of romance. The longer you stay away, I tell my friends that I am fine without you, that I was glad the day you went away. But in the stillness, I'm left with heartbreak. The longer you stay away, in brighter days when we would walk together, and I would hang on every word you say, when love and spring would lighten every footstep, and war was ours with each new day. Say you're lost without me, and by your side I would forever stay. But if you don't pine to be mine, why in time I'll be just fine. The longer you stay away, but if you don't pine to be mine, why in time I'll be just fine. The longer you stay.
If we practiced what Emerson preached. The heart of thee is the heart of all. One blood rolls uninterruptedly, an endless circulation through all men. This might all sound good and well, but the crackpot social logic it engenders hides just beneath the surface. We now will look at a few examples from Emerson's own pen of how foolhardy a truly Emersonian society would be. Consider Emerson's take on paying your bills. In his essay, Circles, Emerson flatly states, "For me, commerce is of trivial import. If a man should dedicate himself to the payment of notes, would not this be injustice? Does he owe no debt but money? And are all claims on him to be postponed to a landlord's or a banker's?" What Emerson seems to be saying is don't pay your bills if you don't feel like it. He never shows any evidence of not having the money to pay these debts. just a cold indifference to them. Now, what would happen if we actually followed this advice as a society? And no one would argue it would be catastrophic. In self-reliance, Emerson counsels one to speak what you think now in hard words, and tomorrow, speak what tomorrow thinks in hard words again, though it contradict everything you said today. Come on, Emerson. You don't even do that yourself. It is difficult to even begin to enumerate the kinds of misunderstandings and foul-ups that would happen in society if you couldn't predict others' behavior from one moment to the next. Furthermore, you would always be blurting out your every thought in hard words, and this would do nothing but make you seem like a loud, obnoxious sociopath, and Emerson himself would agree with that, in practice at least. What about when Emerson states in politics, to educate the wise man, the state exists, and with the appearance of the wise man, the state expires. The appearance of character makes the state unnecessary. The wise man is the state. Okay. Lord, deliver us from the wise man. We don't even know who would be the judge of this wisdom or character. What if the state conferred its own disintegration upon Hitler, Mussolini, or Hirohito, as has happened in the past? Is that what you want, Emerson?
Poopy, doo-doo, duty, caca, diarrhea, turds, crap, loaf, load, log, butt barf, booty juice, stinker, chocolate, bowel movement, nugget, dung, crapola, dookie, feces, pile, poo-poo, scat, stool, the runs, soft serve, dump, steamer, squirts, and shit.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. You're watching the BJ Rubin Show. Thank you.
BJ, I've got some questions to ask you about the last paycheck I got.
What can I do for you, David Earl?
It still hasn't cleared the bank, and I put it in over a week ago.
Well, what do you want me to do about it?
Well, I'm thinking in the future, pay me in cash.
I gave you a cashier's check, Dave. You sure you signed it?
Little buddy. What? You know what I really hate? What do you hate? You know, I see this so often, it just really pisses me off. Somebody wants to get by somebody, and they just stand there and look real dumb, like a zombie. Didn't their mothers teach them to say, excuse me? It's all you gotta say. I know, it's all you gotta say. You wanna get by somebody, you humble yourself, and you say, excuse me. And then they go, oh, okay, and they move out of the way. It's not a big deal, right? No, it doesn't seem like a big deal. Yeah, but yet, I'll see people just standing there, like, waiting, like if they stare at the back of their head long enough, they'll get the idea and move. That's ridiculous! I know, that's how I feel. Sometimes I actually feel, I'm feeling really self-righteous now. I'm sorry. No, go ahead, brother, rap on! But I gotta say that, sometimes I just want to tell these people, hey, since your mom didn't tell you how to do it, here's how you do it. Say, excuse me, and then they move, and then you walk by, okay? Yeah, it's a good plan. Maybe you should start telling people that.
With the lights on for last call, I remember one all my friends and far places from behind me. Lonesome bass and twilight sky. I said evening dreamers, my you set your sights in show business, you're up all night in show business, you fight and fight and never let it go in show business, you're never right in show business, a cash is tight in show business, is a party all right, it's the only business I know in show business, you heave a sigh in show business, rent's too damn high in show business, you reach for the sky but manage still to keep your morals low in show business, it's another try in show business, it's never say die in show business, if the price is right, it's the only business I know. Never stop to contemplate confusion. Where's that amphetamine and coke imbued infusion I've been using? Show business makes you a star. Show business tells people who you are. Show business sends you straight to the bar. It's the only business I know. Show business sends you straight to the bar. It's the only business I know.
Thank you. fight. So important to move. It's a marvelous night for raindrops on roses and when a dog bites.